What is going on, guys? Welcome to the One Reason Podcast. My name's Luke. This is Noah. We got some special guests on here tonight. Tonight is the night before Noah's wedding. So we're super excited. We're celebrating that.
This is a special episode.
Special episode, yes. Special edition of the One Reason Podcast. So, like we said, Noah is getting married tomorrow. So, congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Tonight we're going to be talking about some stories. Just some stories of our past. A couple stories with Ryan, a couple stories with Braden. And just get a lot of... Can you guys hear me?
Can you hear me? Okay.
No.
And so what are we going to talk about first, guys? Ryan, tell your favorite story about us.
Anything.
Okay, probably my favorite story... We were over at Luke's house, and his dog had just passed away, and he was going to show us its grave, and that the night after before that, it rained, and Noah didn't have shoes on, and Luke was fireman carrying him, holding him, suckling him to his breast, and he was walking, and Luke's feet slid out from underneath of him, and he landed flat on his back, and it wasn't good. It wasn't a good time after that. I don't believe we made it to that grave, but
it knocked the air out of me.
Yeah, it wasn't good.
That's the first time I heard that story, and I really thought you were gonna say the rain had like washed the grave. And whenever he fell, you fell into the grave. Like
onto the dog.
Oh God!
He falls in the grave. No, that knocked air. It was one of the Ryan moments where, when Ryan gets the air knocked out of him.
You want me to do it?
Yeah, do it.
Yeah, I go.
We'd be in football. There was a kid. What was it?
We can't say his name.
We're not gonna name drop on
DJ.
It's Wayne Grubbs.
we name
dropped. He hit Ryan one time. He hit him, and Ryan, as soon as he goes down, he goes.
It was half pack.
So
and I have a knot on my knee, and he pushed me down, knocked the breath out of me. It wasn't good.
It was the maddest I've ever seen. Ryan
I was a little off my rocker there.
It was so funny. Okay, Braden, you give your best story.
All right. This is another one about Noah. It's completely different. So I remember whenever Noah used to come over to my house, every single time he would come over, it was guaranteed he was peeing somewhere. He would get so excited. He'd pee anywhere, dude. And I remember one time came over.
In my pants, especially.
Yeah, always in his pants. He never made it to a toilet ever that I can remember. He still doesn't. I had one of those little, like, Black & Decker toolbox things, and the lid was open, and we're standing in there, and Noah starts, like, bouncing up and down, and I'm like, are you all right? And he goes, I'm getting so excited. Peas. In the toolbox. This was last week. This was when he was getting so excited. No, he was like, we were probably 4 or 5, but... 4 or 5 weeks ago, I mean, but it just... It literally every time doesn't matter. It was the one time we went hunting together and we were sitting in the stand. You're like, I gotta pee. I can't.
I don't so remember
you,
this.
We literally, this is when we were in my tree stand. It was, I think, last year, maybe the year before. But we're literally sitting there and we hadn't seen anything. We never seen anything. And you just, I mean, you pee right there. And I guarantee you, we're not gonna see anything after
Kyle
that.
Kyle's about to shoot us. My favorite Braden story has to be the time we're over at his house. We're having like little wars and stuff. And Braden's got a bow in his room, like a real bow. And I'm like, that's sick. And I found he had these swords. And he had like, what are the things called?
Like the sheath.
The sheath. I pulled the sheath off one of the swords. And I was like, I'm going to get Braden's bow. And I'm going to shoot him with the sheath, whatever it's called. Braden's laying in the floor watching like Yo Gabba Gabba or something. He's faced away from me. And I was like, Braden. And he, like, rolled over, so he was exposed, and I was like, I already had it full drawn, like I was, like, Rambo, let the thing eat. Sheep. Right in the family jewels. And I mean, he,
I literally went and locked myself in the bathroom. I think you ended up going home. I was like, I'm not coming out.
In the bathroom. I was like, Braden, are you okay? And he's like, just leave me alone. And I was like, Braden. And I got so scared, I called my memo, and I was like, memo. come get me. You gotta come pick me up. I'm in trouble. Right. So Meanwhile, Judy came to pick me up, and we went to Taco Bell after, and we went home. And I was like, I killed Braden.
Oh, hold on. I got another one real quick. So there was one time it snowed. It was probably, I don't know, like not a ton of snow, probably 2 or 3 inches of snow. Noah wears Crocs constantly. It's about the only thing I've ever seen him wear. It's freaking snow on the ground. And so we're going sledding. And we're out there. And we're sledding for probably like 30 minutes. And Noah's like, man, my feet are cold. And I hadn't even looked. He's in Crocs. Just completely full of snow.
Still. So it's still, still to this day, that's all I wear. The other day, we went hunting. Me and Luke did. And he said, you got your boots on? Got my Crocs on.
I was about to say, I guarantee you said yes, and you show up in a pair of Crocs.
I got the fuzzy Crocs, though. So those
oh, that's different. They're you know, fleece lined.
Oh, but now they've got, what is it, Apple Crush?
Oh, yeah, I spilled the apple. You know that Apple Crush stuff? That
at least they smell
Tiffany
good,
make or whatever? All of my shoes, and they itch my feet so bad now. All right, Luke, tell a story. About anybody.
I mean, there's just so many to tell. Let's see. The one about me dropping Noah was pretty funny. Noah
Tell the bongo man. Tell that story.
So, I don't know if I've told this on the podcast, but Noah is very scared.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He is the biggest chicken that I've ever met.
I'm strong.
And so...
I'm strong, though.
You may be physically strong, but mentally,
mentally you're a wreck.
Yeah, mentally you're a wreck. But we're sitting at my house, and we're upstairs in my room, and I don't remember what we were doing, but
it was night, and no one was there but me, you, and Grace.
Yeah, and so Noah hears this noise outside, and like my window upstairs sits off the ground, like I don't know, like this high, and then it's just window. So Noah, like, crawls up. He crawls on the floor and, like, peeks up over the window and, like, opens the blind and says, dude, there's a guy on your cabin porch playing bongos. And I'm like, what? I'm like, how can you make this up? So I look out.
How could I make that up? Exactly. Like, who thinks of that? Who thinks of a guy playing bongos? Because it was real.
You would.
I looked outside, and there was nothing.
You're, like, hallucinating.
So, and then another story. Noah is also at my house. We're by ourselves, just me, him, and my sister. And we hear this noise in the basement. And we thought somebody had broken in.
Kelly and Tony were gone.
And he goes, we gotta get Grace. We go in my room, and he barricades the door with the futon. And my sister has a BB gun pointed at the door, thinking that somebody's downstairs. And apparently, it turned out that the radio was on or something, and it sounded like somebody talking downstairs.
The funniest part, though, is we had Grace. Grace was, how old was Grace at that time?
She was probably like 4.
No.
4.
She was like 10 or 11. And we were like, Grace, you got to go downstairs with that BB gun and try to help us. So Grace went downstairs.
Oh, she went downstairs first. So, but yeah, Noah, I'm worried about you staying in this house by yourself.
That's what I was going to say. You're not allowed to be afraid anymore.
Oh yeah, you're
it's
the
so
man.
Scary out here though.
You're the man of the house now.
Yeah, those chimes.
Yeah, that's what I was
going
to say. The very first time.
I take them down every day, and Dad puts them back up. I don't know.
Dude. I remember the first night that we stayed here, and that stupid AC over there. Whenever it turns off, it goes like. Every single time we thought somebody was here, we were waking up every 15 minutes and be like, somebody's just playing with us right now.
Dude,
that night that I came for the bachelor party, he said, y'all left, and he said, you're going to stay with me, right? And I said, dude, you're going to have to learn to stay out here by yourself. What is Kenzie going to do when you're working at night and she gets home at 3 o'clock in the afternoon?
Dude, Kenzie's crafty. She's like the daggone Home Alone kid.
She's braver than I am.
She'll get things going.
Dude, that cellar is easily one of the scariest things ever, though. Somebody died down there. It has to.
It's probably got, like, Satan.
Yeah, it's probably got, like, the stars on it.
You didn't see any occult markings anywhere.
Yeah, we're clear.
There's rabbit bones and stuff.
A circle. Like a rock circle.
Oh, my butt's hurting so bad.
Were there Amish on the road when you came through?
No. There's Amish on the road.
It was for us.
Because I was popping over those hills, and there was wagons coming. And then, like, I passed the wagons, and, like, they're, like, candle lit to show you that they're in the road.
That's what me and Adam are talking about.
Because there's so much soot. They have night vision goggles on their lanterns. You can't see nothing.
They don't see. But anyway, I come over another hill and there's three of them walking. In my side of the road, and I'm like, "What in the world?"
You don't need to worry about the supernatural. It's the Amish people.
Luke left. Did you see the guy standing in the middle of the road?
Yes.
He was walking the middle of the road, and it was like 1 o'clock in the morning, just walking the middle of the road.
So I got one for you.
And he goes,
"There's one night. I'm assuming he was a farmer, right? All Amish are farmers, so you know.
And not all of them.
But
some of them are just
some of them might be serial killers. No. So one night, my sister and her husband are on their way home from somewhere, and they're taking this road, right? And they see one of them hitting a pretty light trot down the side of the road, got blood all over him. And they're like, what the heck? Like, number one, what's an Amish doing out? It's late, like 1 o'clock in the morning. And he's running down the side of the road, he's got blood on him. Which, I mean, I'm just assuming he just had to, like, deliver a calf or a horse or something like that. But they were like, he's killed somebody. There's no way he didn't. Side note, I did read something the other day that said the Amish handle a lot of their crimes internally. So, really? I mean, I guess if that did happen.
Yeah.
I don't know if they have to go to the cops. I don't know.
He probably thought it was like 6 o'clock. They don't have clocks. He didn't know it was that late.
His internal clock got flipped around.
He said, it's about to get dark. I'm going
to
hit a light
draw.
Okay.
Oh,
jeez. Got any more good stories?
I got one about Noah Pien. I have about six of Noah Pien.
A leaky bladder?
Dude, first time he ever came into my house, we were...
What 14
were we?
Or 15?
No, we were
6.
We 6 years
young.
Old. It was like
it was first grade.
Yeah, first time I was in Heather's class with him. I had a little bit of a wild dog. Yeah, I had a wild dog. He'd run around.
Wild dog.
No, he wasn't mean. He was
I thought you
he's
said
anxious.
You were a wild dog.
No, it was a bit of a wild dog. But it would just run around in circles and like we were like in my mom's car waiting to like get out and she was like, "Hold on, this dog's here. It's a little crazy." And it ran around the house, and then we got out, and by the time we got out, it was already circled around, coming from, like, the front yard, and it ran straight into Noah's
garage. We jumped on that trailer. We jumped, remember we got on that trailer?
Jumped onto the trailer, and he hurtled and went, clamped on Noah's crotch. And Noah peed in its mouth the first time he stepped foot outside of the car into my house.
Peed
in its mouth.
I peed in my pants. It scared me.
It was also
in his mouth too. He's chilling right there.
I just I just peed in my pants because I got scared.
In the pants, in the mouth.
He was like wringing out a rag.
It was bad. It was really bad.
It was something.
Getting some good urination stories. So.
I got another one, but this one's not actually about Noah peeing. It's a dare from Noah. This one time, I think it was the same night we were sledding.
Peeing?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Why are we talking about peeing still?
This is like easily your greatest trait. He dares me. There's a bunch of people over at our house. We're sledding, having like a get together. So he says, "You won't pee in a Ziploc bag and sit it like, and shove it underneath your sister's bedroom door." And I'm like, "What good could come from it?" But I'm like, "All right, whatever." This was 2 weeks ago. No, I think I was like 7. So I pee in this Ziploc bag and we put it underneath the door, and nothing came of it. Like, we stood outside the door and she was like, "What is that?" But then I just got into trouble. I remember ended up getting grounded and my daddy made me go upstairs while everyone was there. He's like, "A bag full of pee? Really, son?" I said, "Noah told me to do it." He said, "I don't care. I told you to do it."
That was pretty funny. That was good.
Your dares are always the worst.
Were you there the night that me and I know Luke was there and Ryan was there, the Ding Dong Ditching night? Were you
oh, God.
Hit his eye?
Dude.
Hit his eye?
No, he wasn't.
I don't think so.
It was
so.
Logan Majors.
Logan Majors, it was.
Dude.
We went Dig Dog Ditch.
And Trenton.
Trenton, yeah. No.
Yeah.
Damn.
No.
I don't know.
Estavia was there.
No. But we went, and the first person we dunked Dig Dog Ditch was my Memo's. It was Memo and Pepple, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We went down there, rung the doorbell a couple times, took off running. All you hear is Luke going, "Ah!" He's laying on the ground. We go over there to check on him, and he's laying on the ground, like, holding his eye. And we have a picture. We'll
yeah.
Make, it's going to be right here, the picture of Luke.
Dude, it looked bad.
Bad. He cut his eye so bad. And then the rest of the night, we went Deep Dog Ditching.
Like his eyeball?
Yeah, like a stick went in it.
Yeah, the stick.
What?
entered his eyeball.
You know, was it bushes? Fine, or did you have to go to the hospital? Or
the bushes right in his pebble's house.
Oh, wait, the scratch was like this big.
He's different. He's got a dog. A dog. He doesn't have the dog.
I'm not sure if Noah's dad knows this, but we got the cops called on us.
Did like the community Facebook page was like, "Are you guys getting this too?"
Yeah. Oh, no, like, chance.
Calling the cops.
Has it got you all?
We were downstairs in the basement at that point, like freaking out.
But, and your mom was like, "You guys gotta get back in. You gotta get back in.
There's a ding dong ditcher on the loose. You guys are not safe."
But we went to one of the houses up there. I don't know. I think it was me and Logan. That knocked on the door really, really hard.
Oh, yeah.
And they let
their
dog out.
It was me and, no. It was you and Luke. Because me and Logan. me and Logan were laying under a tree. We were
you were behind those pine trees. We knock on this door, and it was a guy we played football with's house. And all we hear is the door open, and we hear. And just like claw marks coming down the concrete. Me and Noah are hauling Hind in down this road.
Turns out it wasn't a dog, it was him.
No. I was under the tree with Logan, and we were prone, and they boom, 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 they knocked, and all I saw the lady go was, didn't even look, just opened the door, let it out, and I was like, Logan, they let their dog out? And it's like halfway through the yard, and I'm like, and he didn't respond. I looked back, he's 30 yards, he got up already, and I was like, oh my God, dude.
I'm kind of glad was I wasn't so there slow. Because I'm easily
so everybody
slow
was impressed that the dog's behind me.
The worst one. Noah told us a cop lived in this house. And it, like, the yard, the front yard's, like, huge.
That freaking no hill.
There's, no like, cover. A small, a small tree with no, like, no branches. It's just, like, a little bitty one, like, you'd have, like, you just planted.
Charlie
and I'm laying under it. And I'm, like, and they're, like, okay, you're going to wait here. And whenever they come out, you're going to tell us what happens. So they run around, and I'm laying there.
That's the one you made me do, and it was an old lady.
It was you. Yeah, I'm laying there. I wait for like 5 minutes. A small, frail old woman.
It's like 10 o'clock in the morning.
She comes like 5 minutes later, and she's like, hello. And I'm just like.
Like 20 yards from the door.
It was one of those where I did it, I ran, and then they said, you got to go back and do it again. They didn't hear you.
Dude, it was.
That
I was
like an
oh
admission of
God
guilt.
Yeah, it was.
You guys are gonna get arrested.
Yeah, it was good.
Allegedly, we allegedly did all these things.
I got another story about Noah being an absolute scaredy cat. So we took a trip down to Gallenberg, like us and a few other people, and we're staying in this cabin. And it's the middle of the night. We've been streaming King of the Hill. They had it up on YouTube 24/7.
The same episode.
And he wakes me up like 2 o'clock in the morning. He goes, "Hey. That closet door was closed when we went to bed." And I was like, "Are you sure?" And he goes, "Yeah, Bray, there's got to be ghosts in here or something." Yeah. Did you actually ever get up and open that, or was it?
No, I watched it. Brain's asleep.
Yo, bull crap. You didn't watch
Brayden,
it open.
I promise you. I'm watching. Brain's asleep, and I'm watching King of the Hill because I'm not sleeping there.
Like, it's Bobby Hill. He goes, "Dad!"
Yeah. But the door, it just goes, and opens a little bit, and I was like,
yeah, but by the time he woke me up, it wasn't even cracked. I mean, it was open. Yeah, and it wasn't even like one of those closet doors you open like this. It was like the shutter style ones. Those things are easy to open.
And there's like nothing in there, though. It was a little bitty closet, like nothing.
This was before he was with Kenzie and he tried to get a girl. And instead of, "You want a burger to go with that shake?" he said, "Hey, you want a burger shake?"
No, I wasn't trying to get a girl.
It was a dare. It was a dare.
We were doing ad practice.
We're on the main street. Allegedly. And she goes, "Hey!" Starts running after the truck.
And then Brayden went up to some guy and goes, you know where Stromboli is?" And he goes, "Yeah, just right down there." It's not even a thing. Like, Brayden just goes, "Yeah." That was pretty good.
We were racing. We went to Dollywood, and we were going down the slides. And the lifeguard, poor thing, she wasn't very good looking. But I said, "No, if I beat you, you got to ask for a number." And did she give it to you or no?
I didn't ask for a number.
Yeah, you did.
No, I just went up to her and was like,
"Ma'am, what time is
it?" I got cheated.
Like, they didn't know what I said, so I just went up and I was like,
"You said, hey, you had a burger shake."
It wasn't nothing like that. I was like, "Hey, can I have two max if I go?" Like, I asked her,
"Hey, do you know
about the ride.
Do you know the number to Dollywood?"
Yeah. That was pretty good.
Somebody want the headphones for a minute? We swap out.
Yeah, I don't want them anymore. I'll let you all hear them because you guys can tell the audio is good.
I can't tell nothing.
Oh, these are like McDonald's headphones.
Yeah.
Oh, those are the ones that came with the metal detector.
I can't hear anything. Say something.
There's no way you
Hello?
Can hear anything.
Hello?
I can hear now.
Can you hear something you now?
You might not have heard a single word Noah said.
Maybe
you
not.
Might not have.
I could hear it in the headphones.
You could.
Yeah.
You don't.
Did you not?
You don't need that. We're going to have a lot of mic interference.
Whoa.
I think, I'm trying to think of a story of Ryan and Braden. I'm trying to get a good story of Ryan.
So, yeah, we've been hitting you pretty hard.
Everything's
been good. I just had one for you, Luke. Literally can't remember it. Like, I literally had it. I had it loaded up.
Y'all can go ahead. But,
one of my favorite Ryan stories. I have two. Both of them involve Chuck. We had one night. It was one day we were sitting there. It was early in the day I came over. We were playing Fortnite. It was when Fortnite was big. Brought my PlayStation. And Ryan came in. I came in, and it was early. And we were playing Fortnite, and all I hear is Chuck go, "Ryan!" And I was like, he sounds mad. Comes in, and he goes, "The dishes aren't clean, Ryan." Ryan forgot to do the dishes the night before. And Chuck starts getting mad at him, so I was like uncomfortable. And then I was like, this is funny. And Ryan's sitting there, and he's so mad. But it was the funniest. I don't know why that's so funny, but I thought that was the funniest thing. And then the other one is, we're at Ryan's house, and it's just me, Ryan, Chuck, and Zach. Elsa was gone, and like Ryan was, that Chuck was going to fix steaks for us that night, and we thought he was outside. And Ryan was, had to change or something, comes out, butt naked, but he's, I can't tell the story.
Easily one of the most classic things, though, is whenever, anytime I go to Noah's, if we stay up past midnight, your dad always has to get up stupid early, and he comes downstairs, he says, "Noah, shut her down, bud. Shut her down." Every time.
He's ticked off, too.
He's always upset.
You always hear his footsteps.
To be fair, I would be ticked. You hear him come downstairs, you're like, "It's Dad." You're like, "Man, I hope that's Sophie." And you know it's not.
Because you hear his footsteps.
Yeah, you know.
And it's always like, "What? I'm asleep." Shut her down.
Yeah.
No.
Asleep.
No. Shut her down.
Shut her down.
That was his, I forgot him saying that. He said that all the time.
Oh, it's classic. There was one time we were being loud. I don't remember specific. We were probably wrestling. But he came down there and he said, "If I have to come down here again, it's not going to be good for you boys."
Braden pooping in the toilet that time.
He still does, I hope he doesn't watch this. Because there's one time I'm at a poop in the basement toilet. And I
and
go upstairs. I've known this. They've lived there for an eternity. It's never worked. And I go upstairs and I ask Todd, I said, "Hey, is that bathroom toilet already pooping?" He goes, "No." I said, "Oh, good, because I was about to." And I'm pretty sure that's when we were supposed to hang out one Sunday, and you ended up having a flake because you were like, something happened to the toilet downstairs, and there started poop coming out from the base of it.
It's because we pooped in. And like, I mean, 17 things of toilet paper to wipe as I did.
There's never a garbage can down there, probably because you're not supposed to poop.
Garbage can?
Yeah.
You don't wipe and throw in the garbage.
No, but you can't flush it down there. Like, I wouldn't have flushed it if there was a can, because I knew, I mean, I'll poop down there, but I'm not going to flush the paper. That never works.
Dude, my mom used to get so mad at Jarrett for wiping his butt and throwing it in the trash can, because she would, like, have to take the trash out and just be poop. It would just be poop.
My favorite thing is when it's, like, sunny side up whenever you go pull it up out of there. Nothing you can do.
Oh, no.
Oh, gosh, how long have we got?
It's not about how long we got, it's about how much battery life this thing's got.
I was going to say it's about how much actual usable stuff you have, because
22%
some of the stuff
easy.
So, I don't know how many seconds is, or how many minutes is 715 seconds.
That's 10
anybody
minutes.
Anybody got one more story
is it really?
To tell?
Yeah. There's 600.
We've only talked for 10 minutes?
That's 11 minutes and 40 seconds.
No, it's not.
700 divided by 60?
No, that's not right. It's more than 1 second each time. See? It's like 2 or 3. It's two seconds each.
2. Okay. I don't know.
Hold on.
What's the top
1,000 is 30 minutes.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. It's just, this thing's complicated. All right,
Ryan, do you got another story or no?
Do you want to hear about me tripodding my deer?
Yeah, still that story.
We'll bring it back to the hunting aspect. Well, it was my first time down at the farm, Luke's family's farm, and it was really the first time I've ever been deer hunting before. And I was hunting with Dad in one of the stands, like, right next to the cabin. And we were waiting there. We were just sitting there. I fell asleep because I like didn't know anything about deer hunting. And I was like, he woke me up and he was like, there's a doe there. And I was like, okay. I was like, okay. He said, you want to shoot it? I was like, yeah. So I was like lined up and I was like, I knew you were supposed to shoot like near that front shoulder of it where the heart is. I took that thing's arm off and it ran off. And I was like sitting there and I was shaking and Dad was like, I don't think he got it. And I was like, really? And I was like probably like 16 or 17.
That was started,
dude, I was bawling.
Was
I was like,
wave.
I was like,
he was so upset.
Dude.
You could blow the shoulder out of it.
Dude, I did some damage.
Straight leg, just leg shoulder.
I did some damage.
Just hurt the knee.
Dude, I was crying.
Just bone.
I was crying. I was like, so I didn't even kill it.
I just hurt it.
You just injured it real bad.
That's why we don't let inexperienced sportsmen in the woods. I'm just kidding.
That's the main thing for this podcast.
What's the main thing for the podcast?
I don't know.
One reason.
One reason is urine and deer hunting.
Those two go hand in hand. You can't go deer hunting without it. Hey, no joke. Do you all use estrus when you go? Like, do you take doe estrus?
I put it on my boots.
I don't put it on my boots. I started doing the hanger things this year.
Did it work?
I didn't see a deer all season.
I will
so
say.
So I have to guess no.
You know those drag things that you tie to your belt and drag them? I have seen where I have walked through the field, had those dragging, and they
and
a buck will just walk.
You.
Yes. No,
no
not
chance.
Follow me. But they will go on that trail. No joke. Whatever.
I'd use the aerosol before, but this year it's so expensive compared to just like the concentrate. Aerosol. Like an axe, but it's doe estrus.
No, I don't think that stuff works.
I think it works because I've used it before. There was one time we went and I sprayed that and then hit a call. And we hadn't seen anything.
This coming from the guy that makes scrapes and uses his own pee.
That works. I promise it works. One of the biggest deer I've ever had on my farm, it worked.
He thinks that he got one big deer that comes up to this scrape that he had pawed out and peed in. A deer comes up and goes and scrapes a leaf out of it and walks away.
Because he's like, what in the world is that?
I sent Luke a picture of a scrape, and I'm calling it, and I'm like, this is the biggest scrape I've ever seen. He goes, probably a doe scrape. It's not even a thing. I was like, you're an idiot.
That looks like it's from an owl.
Look it up, dude.
No, it's not a thing. Man.
With its beak.
It's scraping it.
I was mad at him. I was like, as soon as he said it, I like, hung up, and I was like, he's such an idiot.
You always hang up on me, so it's... gonna try to kill a wood duck in the morning.
Yeah. We are gonna kill a wood duck
in the morning. Is there one here? Mm-hmm. Just chills here?
Oh,
I think you're going hunting. I was like, what the crap? Got a wedding tomorrow.
No, but we do have a future video that's gonna be uploaded and created here before long. So we're super excited about that.
Luke's new boat.
You weren't supposed to. It was a surprise.
Cut that out.
All right. Thank you guys so much for watching. We really appreciate you guys. Thank you guys for joining us on the podcast.
Yeah. Good time here.
Hey, see you at the top.
Happy wedding.